Okay, Campaigner is a song that Neil just does solo on his acoustic guitar on the Decade album. On this particular song, Neil uses a capo. He puts a capo up on his third fret. Now, a capo generally acts, well, not generally, it always acts as a new nut of your guitar. So just pretend that this is the nut now. You're going to play a D shape. Even though the song is in F, the D shape gives you an F now, since this is your new nut. So the song is in the key of F, but I'm just going to talk about the chord names as if you were playing open. So we'll have a D, and so on and so forth. We're going to go through it more in detail here in a second, but let me run through the song to give you an idea of where we're coming from here. The whole song, even though there's three verses, that's everything that's in there. Here are the chords you're going to need to use. Remember, I'm calling them by their regular names, but they're actually different chords because we're capoed. You're going to have a D, a G major 7, that's like a G chord, regular G chord, except you have your first finger on the second fret from the capo. That kind of sound to it. D, G major 7. You're going to have an F sharp major, which is your bar chord, your typical F-shaped bar chord. And then you're going to have your B minor, which is the same way as that F-shaped bar chord, except you move all these three fingers down one string. So from the F sharp to the B minor, it's just a matter of moving everybody down the string. Then you're going to have A, and finally an E. So D, G major 7, F sharp, B minor, A, E, and that's it. It's a very loose strumming song. So just lightly let your pick glide down the strings and have your arm just loosely go up and down, forearm and everything. Okay. The main intro and kind of the harmonic type of thing going on is an effect that you get from lifting your second finger, this finger, your middle finger, up and down on the D chord, and your first finger up and down on the G major 7. So you're going from an open string to the second fret. Same with the D. It sounds like this. Basically does it twice for each chord. Now when I play the open I'm strumming up. When I'm playing the closed with the finger on the second fret, I'm strumming down. So it's like... That's not quite right. I'm playing open when I'm accenting that note. Open. And then accenting with an upstroke on the second, so you can actually hear those notes ring out better. Down. Things he does, you'll accent notes, and you kind of get the accent there by where you put the strumming. I'm accenting those notes with an up strum, but just real loose. Campaign all my life. Campaign D, all my B minor, towards those goals, or that goals. There's a regular G chord, I'm sorry if I didn't mention that, a regular G chord. So campaign D to B minor, towards that G. Now we're going to go from G to F sharp to B minor.
I hardly slept tonight, you left.
B minor.
Our secret's safe.
Now you're going to lift up your one finger and accent that open string.
Our secret's safe and still well kept.
Try to keep your one finger still on the that note there, so you kind of get this effect.
Our secret's safe and still well kept.
So it's...
I hardly slept the night you left. Our secret's safe. Still well kept.
Okay, let's look at the picking.
I hardly slept the night you left. Our secret's safe and still well kept.
You notice I'll be slightly accenting the root notes of the chords by just striking them and then striking the rest of the chord.
Secret's safe and still well kept.
Now A. Got a B minor. It goes back to G.
Even Richard Nixon.
Now the way Neil is picking it now, he's really kind of emphasizing the strokes.
Even Richard Nixon has got soul. A.
So
our secret's safe and still.
Go into your B minor shape, so you're going to be ready to go down to a B chord after you hit this lick. That is the open 5th string, 2nd fret of the 5th string, open 4th string, 2nd fret of the 5th string chord. So it's... I kind of lift up my finger when I hit the open string, so I don't worry about, you know, bumping into my finger. That's what I did. Then open G chord. So it looks like this. G chord, you can do just lift up your finger, open second, open, and back to B minor, open on the 5th string, E. So it looks like this. Let's do that again because it's probably the trickiest part of the song. Then the secret is really to get on that B minor chord when you need to be there, so you're not rushing your fingers around everywhere. Okay, let's put it all together. Perfect either.